Hey everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to draw a jack-o'-lantern. I'm going to teach you how to draw a pumpkin first, and then we can transform it into a jack-o'-lantern. I've gone ahead and done an example for you, and I've colored it in to give you some ideas. All right, so I'm going to clear this off, and all you're going to need is a piece of paper, a pencil, and an eraser, and we'll get started. So the first shape you want to start off with is a nice round oval. So remember, a circle is big and round. Let me make sure I'm on the right page. Let's start there. Okay. So a circle, right? It's nice, big, and round. But an oval is different because it almost looks like you took a circle and pushed in the sides. And so what happens when you push in the sides is it starts to look long, but still round. So this is the shape we're going to start with. We're going to start off with a long oval. And we don't want it too thin, so I don't want a super skinny oval, but I want it to be rather wide. So it's going to be long and wide. So we start off with that nice center oval. And we're going to build onto that oval. So let's start on the right. I'm going to start a little bit below the top, right here on the right side. And I'm going to make another oval that's connected. And it's going to close up on the bottom. So I'm going to do that again. So we're going to start right at the top half, make an oval, come around, and bring it back into the original. So that's going to be one side of the pumpkin. Now, I want this pumpkin to be rather wide, so I'm going to even add another one. So just like this, I'm going to start right about the same height. So right there, I've got this imaginary line. And I'm going to continue to make another oval, and I'm going to close it onto the last. So you can see we kind of have three ovals that look like they're on top of one another. So we're going to do the same thing on the left side that we did on the right. So I'm going to go back to that top point, and this time I'm going to make an oval onto the left side and close it back in. So I've got one oval off to the left. And just like we did here, we're going to add another one. So starting at the top, curving down, and closing back on the original. So there we go. We've got the basic shape of our pumpkin. We can start adding some details to complete the pumpkin. Right in the center, I'm going to draw a rectangle right off the top, and that's going to be the stem of our pumpkin. And I may also add a leaf. So I'm going to make a curve line to a point, and then a point to a curve line back. That's going to be a leaf. And just to make it even more of a leaf, I'm going to put a line right down the middle. Okay. Now, pumpkins grow on vines. So on the other side of that, I'm going to make a swirly line to look like the vine that it grew from. All right, so you could add a couple little scratch lines onto your rectangle up top, which is the little stump. And you could leave it like this. You could just color it in and make it look like a pumpkin. Or if you'd like to continue, we're gonna make a jack-o'-lantern. So we're going to put a little face onto our pumpkin. And that means we're going to need our eraser because we're going to have to erase some of these lines. But don't worry about that yet. So let's start off with some eyes. I'm going to make triangle eyes. And I'm going to start at the center. And I'm going to go off to the right. And I'm going to make one triangle eye to the left. And then I'm going to scoot over. And I'm going to make another triangle to the other side. So I've got two triangle eyes. Now for the nose, I'm going to make a triangle, but I'm going to flip it over. So see how these have the point on the top? The triangle is going to have the point on the bottom for his nose. So I've got two eyes, I've got a nose, and I'm gonna make him happy. So I'm gonna put a smiley face, and I'm gonna give him one big tooth, because I just think they're the cutest thing when they have one tooth. One tooth, which is basically just a little rectangle underneath that smiley face line. And we can complete our smile by adding a curve to the bottom. So now I've got this smile. And what we're gonna do next is I'm gonna zoom in, and then we're gonna get an eraser, and we are going to erase carefully the line that's inside of the triangle. We just wanna take that line away. And when I zoom out, you'll see what I mean. So I'm gonna zoom back into the other eye just so you can see it clearly. And we're gonna erase that line that's going through the triangle. And if you have any other lines that are going through your triangle shapes or your smile in the middle, go ahead and erase those. And now we're going to add just a little bit of extra detail. So right here on the side of the triangle, we're going to make a line down. It's going to be the same kind of line that's on the right side. And we're going to do the same thing to the other eye. So starting at that line on the right, I'm going to copy it, but slightly inward. And what this does is it's going to make our pumpkin look a little bit more three-dimensional. It's going to look like it really does have some cut-out eyes, like a real jack-o'-lantern. Now the nose, we're going to do the same thing. On this right side, we're going to copy that line and just draw a line down. Okay? When you color this, you can put yellow on the inside of those shapes, and it'll look like you've got a candle inside of the jack-o'-lantern and it's shining on the outside. So I'll show you my original, and that way you can get some ideas. All right, so here we go. So there you go. I put the yellow on the inside so it looks like he's glowing. And I've added some grass and a blue, dark blue sky with a moon and some little bat shapes just for fun. All right, guys, well, I hope you had fun, and I hope you're getting ready to celebrate the month of October. All right, guys, see you next time. Bye.